My master. Safe. The scriptures. Sound. All I ever wanted was a life in my mountain, free from you and your so-called merits. Those high above don't trust me. I understand that. And they send you and those knuckleheads to threaten me. To obey and serve once more. I understand that too. But what I don't understand is... You bastards killing my kind!
Not just any monkey. He's a monkey of merit. A monkey was made Buddha once. None other than me can challenge him to a duel. Look, monkey. I don't make a habit of fighting someone I've bested before. Here's my offer. If you lose, I'll take you to the Celestial Court. They will stay and level your mountain. But if I lose, I shall certainly take revenge, and they will level your mountain nonetheless. How tragic would that be, huh? You are one of the court. We don't need to resort to violence. How about you bend the knees, admit the wrongs, and we can put this behind us?
All these years, except for that pig. You're the one who talks the tallest tales. Good, I am entertained. Speaking of entertainment, wouldn't it be fun if I pluck your extra eye out for my snack and allow you to keep the other two? Because I'd hate to let you miss how I'll slaughter each mongrel of the court. Those below, those above, and that black mutt of yours. Come at me, all of you!
They gave you many chances, yet you spurned each one. Such an fighting Buddha. Have you any idea how many would give their everything for immortality?
Immortality? For that word, all realms and beings have ruined themselves.
Ah!
celestial court welcomed you, foul monkey, yet you remain untamed. None shall save you now.
Dear brother, your edge needs homing. Good. I was in need of a back scratcher.
Celestial. To be honest, I just can't bear your hypocrisy.
And so ends the last tale of Sun Wukong. A hero who treasured his freedom above all else. Buddhahood he attained, yes, but cumbersome he found the celestial rules, for he yearned to come back and to revel in the simple joys with us. Little did he know, his choice to forgo the life above only fueled their mistrust. This stone has stood for countless days on the mountain. Since my youth, they've said that his remains lie within it. Unbegotten, undying, such is the nature of a stone monkey. Though his body was broken, his spirit endures. Into 6 relics he turned, and separately they escaped, choosing to stay hidden. Those are the 6 senses of the great sage. Yet no one has ever seen them, not in centuries. I'm old now. Venture through all the lands, I cannot. Yet among you, there might be one who is destined. One that shall recover all his scattered relics. And upon the return of the relics to Mount Tuaguo, he may yet rise again.
On the gold bend, the toll life of human are for gold.
Nowhere better than a home. We cheat death and ever grow.
Huh?
Here, you see. What bliss my fate shows.
Well, luck's around the corner. Seems like he just fell from a fruit tree here.
Perfect timing. This peach knew I needed a snack. You sneaky rascal! Dare to fool me? I'll make sure you regret it!
No matter how many times you come around, you're still as mischievous as ever, eh?
Thank you. 呀，发什么呆？把个毛来拜一拜。等等，小神是黑风山的土地。 在此候你多时，真香，真香！再往前走，就是观音禅院，当年也是香火鼎盛，只可惜那场大火哟。 后来呀，这禅院又被重建了，可人心若是烧没了，修好一座破庙又有什么用呢？你不记得此地却是有些东西惦记着你。 久不用，没成想这定身术倒还好使。既是花果山来的故人，教你一招也无妨。来。
速速把手伸来。写好了，日后遇到什么凶匪恶徒，只消用着手一指，心里默念一声定，就能让对方动弹不得，你也可喘息片刻。只是小老儿道行浅薄，这定身效果不消片刻就会失灵，遇到些笨货倒还好用，你全当是挣个傍身的手段吧。如今这些小儿真是目无尊长，别怕，刚学的法术与他玩玩。
识相点，我家大王爷爷神通广大。
知深浅的这么往前硬闯，只怕得吃大苦头。我且把你变为一只金蝉，你可顺着前面的火光探一探这山中的虚实。小庙还有诸多神奇妙用，日后你自会明白。
黑风山的后山重地藏着不少秘密，想四处探探的话，务必留神金蝉的存续时间。中途迷路之处，小神自会暗中提点，放心去吧。
是来朝贡的。
口上，小心惊动了那条大狗。后院内似是黑风怪的道友，自称灵虚子，以你现在的道行，快走了。小猴子快逃，还来得及。你若进了这道门，先把这里翻个底儿朝天，那黑风怪赏了灵虚子一颗金丹，若是寻到此物，就算没把。
是猴子，真是猴子！今日若不杀你，大王和真人怪兽。真有不识奇礼。
久在樊笼里，复得返自然。
路上可曾见到那些无主的孤魂？灵运不散，浮于空中。唉，可惜你的葫芦不中用。我这葫芦又认主，哎呀，哎，我有一法，可超度孤魂，归权返真，与你必有帮助。这才像样，不能装天，却可渡人。 荡去痴念，早入轮回。继承天命，
自是无。
你我无非都是这茫茫地。
Thank you.